Most of you already know that there exist machine learning algorithms like linear regression, multiple linear regression, in the regression family of algorithms. But do you know that there are several other types of algorithms available as well? So just like polynomial regression, we have another algorithm called decision tree regression, which is also used to predict target variable values in a non-linear fashion. Meaning the best fit line is not going to be a straight line, just like we have in multiple linear regression and simple linear regression. So in this video, I'm going to cover the intuition behind another type of regression algorithm called decision tree regression. In the subsequent videos, I'm going to cover the step-by-step process to develop and train decision tree regression model using Python. So stay tuned. Hello folks, Nitin here, and this is the AI University channel where you can learn all your favorite digital technologies like machine learning, deep learning, AI, big data, Hadoop, virtual reality, augmented reality, and cloud computing. If you are new here, then consider subscribing to this channel, or if you have already subscribed, then click on the bell icon to receive the notifications about hottest technologies of 21st century. So before proceeding to the decision tree regression algorithm, let's first go through some common terms used in decision tree context. So number one concept is parent-child node. So a parent node is one which gets divided into several sub-nodes. So this node shown on the screen is a parent node here. And on the other hand, sub-nodes are the child of this parent node. So these are the child nodes. Now, if this parent node is at the top level, that meaning it is the top level node which contains the entire population data, then it is referred as root node. Number two concept is splitting, which means dividing a node into two or more subnodes. So here we can see that this parent node is split into two subnodes. Number three concept is subtree or branch, which actually represents a small section or part of entire tree. So if I divide this subnode into two or more subnodes, then this section will referred as subtree or branch. Number four concept is decision node. So if we split this subnode into two or more subnodes, then this node will be referred as decision node. Number five concept is terminal or leaf node. So the bottom level nodes which can't be divided or split further are called terminal leaf node. Number six concept is pruning. So pruning is the process of removing subnodes of a decision tree. So if I remove this subnode of our decision node, then it will be referred as pruning. Moving on. So now the ultimate question is, what is decision tree? Well, a decision tree is a supervised machine learning model which is used to predict a target variable by learning decision rules from associated features. Using decision trees, we can make decision by using a flowchart-like tree structure, just like shown here. In decision tree, we generally break down our data by making a decision based on series of yes or no questions. This path from root to leaf is called a classification rule. Now, each of these internal nodes represent an attribute on which a particular decision needs to be taken. For example, consider an attribute called weather condition from weather data set, which has options as rainy, cloudy, and sunny. So each of these leaf node represents a label, which is nothing but final decision taken after the computation of all the attributes. Decision tree algorithms are sometimes referred as classification and regression trees because these are suited very well for solving problems related to both regression as well as classification. Decision tree regression is a non-linear regression, so keep in mind. In case of regression tree, the value obtained by terminal node in the data set or training set is the mean response of observation falling in that region. Hence, if an unseen data point falls in that region, then we can make its prediction with an average or mean value. This is something which I am going to explain and show you very shortly. So decision tree is good for getting predictions related to both continuous as well as categorical target variables. Decision tree regression is used when we want to predict the target variable whose value is continuous in nature, like values like 4.1, 4.3, 4.5, etc. So on a high level, here is the three-step process to solve a problem using decision trees. Number one is, first we position the best attribute of data set at the root of the tree. Now split the data set or training set into subsets such that each subset contains the homogeneous data. In other words, contains the data having same value for an attribute. Third step is to repeat step 1 and 2 on each subset until you find leaf node in all the branches of the tree. Now, based on type of target variable, we can select the specific decision tree algorithm. So there are various decision tree algorithms or ways using which we can do split of training data or data set. The most popular ones are ID3, C4.5, Kate, and Mars. Please note that explanation of how the split happens using these algorithms is out of the scope of this video, and I will create maybe a separate video or videos to explain each one of them. For now, just keep in mind how and where these splits should happen. This can be handled by algorithm by itself. So now let's make an example and show the entire process in detail. Please note that we are using decision tree regression here because we want to predict the value of continuous target variable called total amount, whose values are continuous in nature. I will be showing details around split happening on data set on left hand side, and corresponding decision tree will be getting created based on that split at the right hand side. So let's consider we have this hypothetical data shown in terms of blue dots, and it has two independent variables, card size and frequency, and it also has one dependent variable called total amount. So total amount is also the variable we want to predict. So basically we have three dimensional data, but for the sake of simplicity, I'm not showing the total amount on the screen, which can be represented on z-axis. Okay. So if you are wondering how it can be represented in three-dimensional space, then this is how it will look like. So when you run the decision tree regression algorithm on this data, then it will divide or split the entire data into segments. So let's say first it creates a split one on variable card size at the value 10, thereby dividing the data into two parts. So observations to the left of this split will represent card size less than 10. And observations to the right will represent card size greater than 10. Let's move on to the right hand side. So from decision tree perspective, the split or decision will look something like this. Now next split happens for independent variable frequency to the left side of split 1 and at the value 25, dividing the data into two parts. We name this split as split 2. So observations below split 2 will represent frequency less than 25, and observations above split 2 will represent frequency greater than 25. Now move on to the right hand side. So from decision tree perspective, the split 2 happened at 25 and only to the left side of the split 1. So split or decision will look something like this. On the similar lines, split 3 happened at right side at value 35 for the independent variable frequency. So observations below split 3 will represent frequency less than 35, and observations above split 3 will represent frequency greater than 35. Let's move on to the right hand side now. So from decision tree perspective, the split 3 happened at the 35 and only to the right hand side of the split 1. So split or decision will look something like this. Lastly, split 4 happens for independent variable card size at 18 and to the right of the split 1 and below split 3. So decision or split will look something like this for split 4. As mentioned earlier, algorithm will decide by itself on how and where these split will happen in an optimal way. Now the next step is to predict the total amount for any new observation which can get added on this scatter plot. For example, we want to predict the total amount having the card size value as 5 and frequency as 50. So you can visualize the new data point added on this scatter plot having card size as 5 and frequency as 50. So it's kind of falling here in this terminal leaf. So how we predict a total amount? Well, now since we have information of all the terminal leaves, so we will take the average of observations in that terminal leaf where this data point is falling. So our data point is falling in this terminal leaf. So we essentially take an average of total amount for the observations given in this terminal leaf. And that will be our predictive value for the new observation. So let's say we got average for total amount for this terminal leaf as 101, for this one 12, for this one minus 49, for this one 514, and for this one 217. So for new observation which fall in this terminal leaf, the decision tree regression algorithm will predict the value of total amount as 101. So now we can add and visualize the decision tree regression predicted values in the decision tree like this. So now if you want to predict the total amount for any new observation, you can just follow the edge and node path to get the corresponding predicted value. So folks, this is it for this video. In the next upcoming video, I will be showing you how to develop and train decision tree regression based machine learning model. So here is the today's question. In order to predict the value of new target variable, do we take average or maximum value of all the observations of a particular terminal leaf in decision tree algorithm? Please post your answers, comments in the comment section given below so that I can get a chance to incorporate your feedback. You can also post your technical questions in the comment section and I will try to answer the same. If you are watching this video and you are not already a subscriber to our channel, consider clicking that little subscribe button. In case you have already subscribed, then click on the bell icon to receive the notifications whenever I will release a new video. So thanks for hanging out with me guys. I will be covering next topic in the upcoming videos. So keep on watching. Thank you.